You know, I don't know if hopefully.
Sounds good. Thank you, Seth. Candace and I both live very close.
He would recommend you study. I will hear you more.
Right.
So I understand that.
when I was out taking the pictures, the resident that was right on that corner, my understanding is that she and her family are not really that concerned because there's no sidewalks, there's kids playing in the area, there's a lot of traffic that is going to be driving back and forth, and trying to cut through St. Francis to get that. They just felt that a four-way stop would be ideal there. I brought this up at the parking head meeting, which all the parking heads were there. They voiced their opinion to them, spot for a four-way stop. They're the ones giving them off the complaints to the position. So if that was his opinion, as far as crash data, again, going back to the last 2 years since I've been here, we have a fall crash at that intersection. Luckily, we don't have a lot of crashes in our residence area. Most of our crashes happen on the town, church.
So.
Not just the development, but
So I think there's, you know, an overall fear of extra traffic and people cutting through. I think because it goes off the hill point, I don't think there's going to be a ton of cutting through. I can tell you currently, I have a home office and I sit looking at Laufenberg and, you know, have for 4 or 5 years. It's a fairly quiet street. And, you know, I'm not a huge fan of the design. I don't think we should ever do that again in Cross Plains. We have the grass in the middle. I think I wish, quite honestly, it was more like down on, you know, this way. So we aren't going to fix or change that. I also know typically as developments fill up, it's, you know, 5 or 10 houses a year. It's typically not all 60 all at once. So I think there will be a gradual increase. I think we should monitor, and we should also work with the neighbors that had the concerns. I know there's a number of them, and, you know, I want things to be done right and safe in my neighborhood too. I think it's a little premature to take action on the borders now. Quite honestly, you know, as we're talking through all three of the suggestions, if we do need to mitigate something because of speed and more traffic, that would be the first one I would think of and be willing to approve, because I think it makes the most sense that people, if there's more traffic. Absolutely. And I know the village president has heard multiple times from neighbors on this particular subject. I definitely think we should monitor, see how the infill is of the houses, see how long that can take. And then see if there's any kind of issue, I think we should take action. And I think before was outside. Everybody okay with not taking action on four? Okay. I'm in complete agreement. And I personally think the traffic study right now wouldn't show a need for any mitigation options. I think after we get a phase of 20-25 houses built, which will take some time, then a traffic study would be wise. Absolutely. Five, discussion and possible action regarding lowering speed limit from 25 miles per hour on Laughlin Loop Boulevard. I think probably the call for this is mainly when there's a lot of cars. I've always had a fear living there since 03. I bought one of the first lots. They did not show how the road was going to be. I knew where it was, but I didn't know it was going to have that stuff in the middle. I've always had a fear of when there's a lot of parked cars that kids popping off. Thankfully, I can't think of even a near miss when something like that happens. I do see the potential. I think that's kind of the idea of the no parking. And I think as a traffic engineer, I think not having parking can make people go even faster. So got a better. We have to balance, safety. The roads are designed for motorized vehicles. Our pedestrians can help us be safe as well, and I think they do a pretty good job of it, which is thankfully why we haven't had an incident there. That was a big concern after moving in. I, as far as like historical for our committee in the village, almost all of our streets are 25. Bourbon and Main are 30, and then I think Mill Creek Parkway is 20. I think we've all probably seen in the paper a little bit more of a push some Madison streets going to 20. I think maybe they can get us some data, and if it's helpful to anything, if we will, we talk about slowing the speed limit. And I'd kind of lump it in with four, just like Andy said. I don't think we should take action before we have people in those houses. I think the concern is when that's a little more full, when that road is open, that road's probably months from being open, 6 months or more for a new home because, the road's got to be put in. I think maybe it's good to have the discussion so we're all aware of it, and then we can take some action and start to see some more numbers.
No. through today. One might assume that it's not going to give me easier. It might seem to make me different. For that study, I don't know if there's merit in studying in advance of opening up long version if you all have nothing. But if there's a baseline issue that we have today, that's
They're supposed to try to have the roads and things like that, I think, done by spring. I'm not sure. That's something we can check into. The board approvals and stuff like that were 6 or 8 months ago. It was before my term started. Then I don't recall the exact dates. As far as us, buying our lot, that was always assumed they would go through eventually. But I know that's not always common knowledge. I don't want to make another problem. I can tell you the biggest thing I see is people just want to stop. It's not just our value. That's probably the number one thing to see is the inattentiveness of the stop sign. We can get a little more data, and I'm sure it sounds like there's a group of neighbors kind of working with JT to communicate. So we can go to that too. So no action on 5. 6 was same street regarding exploring no parking on block. Of those three things, that probably be my last.
To reflect on, and that's not just putting down consensus, we wouldn't take no action at this time. I believe it's based on residents of the participation of concern. At some point, possibly. Traffic study after I put down 25 homes. That's what I think.
Yeah.
That would be probably the significant.
Yeah.
So I can reflect that.
I think that sounds good, really, for all three. The solutions for me have different. I'd rank them, or there'd be one I'd do or the other, but I think it needs to have a concern first and then see what the best action is to address. Go ahead.
I will be sending specifically these items for Jay and Bill because it's really concerns from that area. So I think
sounds good. Maybe as the road opens, we'll get some more homes in there. We can invite them to a meeting and just talk about that.
Good luck, Thomas.